around the Rose Bowl here in Pasadena, where the Michigan Wolverines and the UCLA Bruins are going to butt heads in just a few minutes. They play on grass, though. There has been a breeze over the last couple of hours. It is not that uncomfortable down on the field. So I don't think the Michigan Wolverines, for one, are going to have any trouble this early in the season adjusting with the temperature of Southern California. The Santa Ana winds, the old devil winds, are the factor that produce this kind of heat this time of year in this part of the country. And it can get pretty doggone hot in the month of September. All right, for the sake of perspective, let's consider what has happened earlier in the day. As Roger told you, Notre Dame won their game. The Southern California Trojans across town today, and the Notre Dame score was 21-13 over Michigan State, and the Spartans had a chance at it. And right now, the Michigan Wolverines, who were losers last week by a matter of 5 points to Notre Dame at Ann Arbor, have come into the stadium. And now the UCLA Bruins, with a record of 1-1, come into the Rose Bowl. They were walloped by Tennessee. I mean, they were slapped around by the Volunteers. They barely escaped against San Diego State. And Terry Donahue and his
Buffalo today, but I think Bo is going to go back to his run, and I think to win.
Bruins show a six-man front. Here goes Bowles with the ball. Pursuit to the outside by UCLA is not bad. Tony picks up a couple of yards. Gerbach is a 6'5" redshirt freshman out of Willoughby Hills, Ohio. Leroy Horde was the MVP in the Rose Bowl January 1st. Tony Bowles in there. The asterisks mean returning starters. Chris Callaway, Greg McMurtry, the wideouts. Along the front now, Michigan going into this ball game has two sophomores, a junior, and two freshmen because of injuries and illness. That is a very tender spot for this football team tonight. Second down and 8. It's Bowles with a hole over the left side. Close to the first down. They'll mark him a yard short. The defense for UCLA, they are young at some key positions and thin defensively, and as Terry Donahue says, kind of slow-footed with Lotus Kelly and Wilcox, the down people. The backers are Keaton. Craig Davis is the real ringleader of that bunch. Meet Shaw and Marcus Patton. The secondary, Beverly, Darby, Turner, Lambert. That's a good secondary. That Darby and Turner will take your hat off.
They don't have as much speed as they've had in the past, and that is a concern of Donahue.
Third down and a short yard. Horde carried, and I don't know if he made it. Just skip him. He took a lick right at the top of the stack. It might have been Eric Turner, the free safety, that came flying into the stack and belted it. It'll be very close. They'll probably have to bring
the interior man. The two in yellow are redshirt freshmen. First start for Elliott, second start for Everett.
Michigan shows blitz, don't go. Johnson back to throw. Gets some heat, gets it off underneath. And making the catch is Brown with a good move. Brian Brown picks up the first down as he jukes David Key. Refused to let Key get a solid shot at it and picked up the first down. Terry Donahue and
Tulsa. Receivers to the left side to recover. He hit his check down, his outlet receiver, which was Brown, caught his second pass of the game.
Far back in, they messenger the plays in as UCLA. Johnson gives that ball to Brian Brown, and Brown is hit by Vada Murray, number 37, and will not pick up the first and all. It's Eric Anderson, 37. 30 instead of 20. So Eric Anderson gets his first solo of the night, a 235-pound sophomore from Glenview, Illinois.
Top of your screen, number 37, is Anderson. Just a little delay. Plays off the block of Meyer, 71. And he gets some help.
Fourth and short. Well, here's some daring do for you. It's fourth down and a little over a half a yard, and they're going to go for it. A rather large gamble early in the ball game. The quarterback, Brett Johnson, sticks his head in the stack, and it's very close. Just depends on the mark.
That is a big gamble coming in. Schembechler's defenses have always been good. In fact, second in the Big Ten against the run. This year, Donahue's offense not doing so well on the ground.
UCLA confidently walking away, saying, okay, we got it. But I don't think so.
You know, this is
when
a quarterback goes into a mass of humanity, who's running behind Frank Cornish, is all Pac-10 center, but it's just, you're at the mercy of where the official spots the ball.
Oh, he did get it. Not that much. Woo. I bet you Terry's stomach just calmed down a whole lot right there. Because you give Michigan the ball on your own 44-yard line early like this, that's asking for trouble.
Well, if it works, it sends a message to your team, not only your offense on the field, but your defense, that, hey, we're going to go out and attack this team, Michigan. They're on our property. We're going to go out and show them we can play ball.
Estwick is out of there now as UCLA goes to the single back offense. They were burned by Washington State last year, but they've incorporated some of it in their own attack. Johnson goes deep with it, and there's a fine play by Veda Murray. The intended receiver was down there, and he was available. It looked to me like
back deep to receive.
Low kick, long kick. Goldman lets it go, hits inside the five. In traffic, running hard for 11 yards and a Michigan first down. I think Leroy likes this turf.
Well, as you mentioned, he was the Rose Bowl MVP last January 1. 42 yards, two touchdowns, and was the leading ball carrier against Notre Dame last week. I think these are good calls. Gary Molo, the offensive coordinator, sending in the plays. Letting Gerbach, who is starting his first game.
Yeah, your stomach gets tight.
All week.
On first down, Horde again. Really from are. The 31 up to the 35. Whereas in the West are still five back as the Giants beat Houston today. All right, here goes Tony Bowles for Michigan. And that's another Wolverine first down. So Bowles' heart's warm now. They run the ball for a couple of first downs.
1,400 yards last year. His two tailbacks gained over 2,000 yards, Bowles and Horde.
Well, you talk about matchups. It's a very important thing to talk about how people match up, how teams match up at individual positions. Bowles last week got 17 yards against the Irish. That Michigan has. All right, here's a speedster going in motion. This is Desmond Howard. He can fly. Gerbach with a good action on the play, dropping back, giving the ball to Tony Bowles. Passing time possibly here on third down at long five. Gerbach back to three wideouts, gets his ball off down the middle, through the ball, and the crowd intercepted on the rebound. It is picked off by Deion Lambert, and UCLA has the ball around their own 45-yard line. He tried to
pass and throw the ball downfield. The linebacker almost gets a piece of it. The defensive back gets a piece of it, and it's picked off on a deflection. There's the linebacker, Davis, 54. Craig Davis, ball is deflected off into the air, and Lambert, number 26, picks it off.
Galloway had no real chance to catch that ball at all.
We're talking about the quarterbacks, Aikman last year and Brett Johnson. It's interesting to note the amount of the play calling has gone on this year as opposed to last year. We'll show you an interesting stat here in a minute.
You hope. On third down, Brett Johnson back, comes it to the sidelines, pass is caught by Richardson, and it'll be first down UCLA at the Michigan 10-yard line. And they picked on Dutton.
That was a good catch by Richardson, but the class of Johnson staying cool in the pocket, rolling a little bit to his left, gets a little bit better protection. Take a look right here. Last year, 239 yards when Aikman was a quarterback. This year, with a redshirt freshman, they're averaging 264 per game.
It'll be officially at the nine. Johnson sprints out. Drills out there, throws a block pass into the end zone, over the head of the intended man, Farr, because Farr was double covered. Don't give it away down here.
Oh, that shows a little experience right there. Nobody was open. He threw the ball out of the end zone. 5 of 9 with 53 yards, and he's picked up four first downs through the air so far today.
John Milligan, who had been in at the inside backer position for Michigan, comes out now, and J.J. Grant goes back. for UCLA, second down and goal, just inside the 10. Arbuckle is in there, number 81 now, as they go back to the one-back set. Wills is the lone remaining back. Wills has the ball, and Wills gets down to about the 5. All right, where did Arbuckle go?
Well, he was
blocking that time. When you get down here, though, you got to look out for him because he's a big, big target, and he's a very good pass receiver.
Well, all of their tight ends. In fact, their tight ends last year.
They put Espert back in the ball game and take Arbuckle out.
They'd be so sure.
Estwick in front of Wills. Just short. Fullback leading, and I tell you what, Big Mark Estwick moves some folks around. He's up to 240 pounds, and Wills is hurt. Or he just had a little trouble getting on track. He's beaten on the ground because he didn't score. That's what.
You were right about Estwick in front of Wills, number 22. Let's see if you see the block. He gets right there on key, 26. Puts him in the end zone. Good blocking up front.
Just short.
Relax. Start having more fun. Get your priorities straight. See you later.
Redshirt freshman from Texas, Estwick is the fullback. Williams gets it and scores.
Officials agree. You break the plane of the goal line, it's a touchdown.
And the man in the white hat called it a touchdown.
Unless the ball was out before he crosses, and the official at the bottom may not have seen it. If the ball is out before he crosses, the umpire straight behind him would be able to see it best.
No, he's over. He scored.
That was awful close. It was tough to tell from that angle there, but...
Well, he was coming down when the ball came out. I don't know where... From that angle, you can't really tell where he is.
Take a look at this angle. Well, that's a great shot of the ball coming out, but you don't know whether he crossed that line or not.
But the man in the white hat called it a touchdown, and here's the extra point try by Alfredo Velasco, and it is good. And so UCLA goes 54 yards, use 4 minutes and 51 seconds, and takes the lead 7-0.
Well, that this year, they had some close ones.
They haven't been really tested either. It'll be the 19-yard line for Michigan, with Gerbach, the quarterback, Bowles, and Horde lined up behind him. And UCLA leading after a 54-yard drive, 7-0. Gerbach, throw, getting pressure, and down he goes. Mike Lotish, who went to... And Gerbach will get it away to the sidelines. Got a man, pass is good, caught by Desmond Howard. And the quarter is over. The catch is made out beyond the 25. Score 7-0. Wolverine, this arguable touchdown, UCLA leading 7-0.
And that is close. The man at the bottom, the official at the bottom, the linesman, makes the call. And I think it was a good call, although it was hard to see from any of the angles that we had.
It is now third down and 2, Michigan, at their 27 with Horn and Bowles in the backfield. And here's some trouble for Leroy Horde. There's a penalty flag thrown as he is forced behind the line of scrimmage by Meech. Late hit on the quarterback. Somebody got a little carried away and popped Gerbach. And that's going to give the Wolverines a first down.
The interesting statistics in the first quarter, the bottom two, the turnovers and time of possession. UCLA dominating time of possession, and the turnover, the interception by Gerbach, leading to the only score by UCLA. Interesting that last week Notre Dame scored on after a turnover by Michigan also. Their only score offensively. Top left, Gerbach getting hit. That is probably what the
Lotish, I think,
personal foul was.
Yep, it was. I'm sure it was because you're right in front of the referee.
you're going to do that, you ought not to have somebody wearing a striped shirt standing there looking at you.
42-yard line, first down for Michigan. Bruins lead 7-0, just starting the second quarter of play from the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. This is Bowles losing a couple of yards. That Bruin defensive bunch swarming tonight. A little bit of a delay goes to Leroy Horde. Not a lot there. He got up there about 2 yards, and then they threw him back three. For Elvis Gerbach, a little different sort of a circumstance. At least that's the opinion of his coach this week.
I've seen guys come off the bench and kind of freewheel it and look great. Then all of a sudden, when they have to take on a whole game, they don't look as good. I don't think that'll happen to him. I really think that he'll play extremely well in this ball game. If he doesn't, I'll be disappointed, but I think he'll play well.
So far, he's been intercepted once that set off the UCLA touchdown, but here's a very good pass thrown to the tight end, Derek Walker, and good for about 8 or 9 yards. It is short of the first down.
Wasn't where he wanted to throw the ball. Look at 75 Skrepanek and Patton, number 49. Skrepanek goes about 240, but it's the speed and quickness of Patton that gets around the big man and takes him down.
So that third down pass is not good enough, and it brings up fourth and four.
Skrepanek goes about 340.
Yeah, they'll love him in the NFL pass blocking.
Yeah.
But he ain't knocking none of those little guys out of there right now.
That was a good shot because speed would normally get around the big size.
Hunt is away by Stapleton. Penalty flag is down. Bruins have the ball. This is Wills looking for a crack. And he can't find it. And he's dropped on about the 17-yard line by Tripp Welburn. Let's see about the flag thrown back upfield. 40-yard punt, 6-yard return. Penalty goes against Michigan. And I would imagine the Bruins will want him to kick it again because right now the ball is resting short of the 18.
Be blocked by one of these people up front, and when you hit it, a man and hit the punter in college, it's a penalty. Look right there at the bottom of your screen. In the pros, if you're blocked into the punter, it is not a penalty. He's clearly blocked into him, hits him. There's no way you can control your body. You're doing a flip. It takes away some of the aggression from the defensive team rushing the punter.
And there's no judgment involved.
No.
I mean, it's very clearly, plainly, the rule is terribly specific. We went over it and over it and over it and over it and over it. And Dave Nelson drew us pictures about it.
Well, it's flat out put in there to protect the punter. I mean, they want to protect him at all costs. It takes some of the aggressiveness away.
Goes down the middle. Deep in the end zone and incomplete, almost covered by, I think, Michigan. They do. I don't know how, but they do. The Horde fumbles the ball. Third and three. Pressure coming. Pass away. Pass is good. And the pass will be good for a first down to Tony Bowles. But just barely. Not by a whole lot. Meach Shaw came in a hurry to get him.
And I think that's a good call. Just get the young man settled down a little bit. He had all week to think about this start. He played well.
Officials are not going to do anything the rest of the night now to make this crowd happy. I don't think. From the 32, first down, Michigan. 11.5 minutes remaining in the first half of play. They go to the wishbone now. New look in the game. Leggett in for Michigan. Joining Bowles and Horde. Leggett is 46. Ball goes to Horde. And Leroy, a junior out of New Orleans, Louisiana, will pick up a couple of yards, maybe three, over the right side. Gerbach Lost one to the corner for Callaway. Callaway is pushed. A bump. And no flag. Michael Williams was defending for UCLA and came very close, but not quite. Here they bumped together.
Well, the ball was poorly thrown. He threw it back to the center of the field. If the ball would have been thrown out toward the flag, he could have caught it. Both players were going for the ball. No interference there, but the fact is it was a poorly thrown ball. Should have been thrown more to the corner.
Yeah, he's throwing rainbows right now.
Yeah, and he needed to throw that ball outside more.
Put something on it.
Yeah, he didn't need as much air. He just needed it to look flatter and get it there a little quicker. But he'll settle down.
Third and seven and timeout. 10.5 minutes to go in the first half. UCLA 7-0.
Pretty straight. Start having more fun. May we make a suggestion?
Throw it. Pressure coming. Passes away. Out of bounds. Incomplete. I tell you what, Gerback is very fortunate he was able to get it away. Oakland having won their game. So I guess Oakland lost to Minnesota. But nonetheless, when you lose two and you're fullback this late in the season, you got trouble.
With a week to go, you lose two, you should be out.
That's right. J.D. Carlson, the sophomore out of Tallahassee. A 46-yard field goal try. He got enough foot on it. And he made it. From 46 yards, Michigan gets on the board. And it's a 7-3 ball game. Albertson doing the kicking off to give you an idea of some of the searching that Bo Schembechler is still doing. Mind you, he's absent a lot of folks in that starting front tonight, as we told you. The illness is Dean Dingman has lost some 30 pounds with throat infection.
Dingman is not here. Ramirez, their other starting guard, is not here. And, of course, Michael Taylor, starting quarterback
Fullback.
Jared Bunch is out. Four starters, not here.
All right, your deep people for UCLA are Kevin Williams and Brian Brown, two tailbacks. Standing just inside the five. 10:18 to go in the first half. 7-3. UCLA leading. Albertson to kick it.
Unable to stop him.
Johnson throws it. Touchdown. Scott Miller. Alfredo Velasco for the extra point try out of a hold of Maggio. Good. With their offensive team. And Brett Johnson has been particularly effective in his outing against his first really big name Big Ten opponent. Caliuso gets it inside to the one where it's bobbled around and finally picked up by Tony Bowles. It was bobbled by Howard, picked up by Bowles, and Tony makes it a big play. Carlton Gray finally ran him down, so he's up way out beyond the 35, making the 40-yard line. Bob mentioned that Scott Miller and Brett Johnson were high school teammates.
Throwing the football to him.
At the 41, first down for Michigan now. And this is Leroy Horde, and he picks up about 3 yards. Kelly, 65, and Lodish, 94. Of course, this figured to be a game that if he was going to jack up, he would jack up for this one. Leg it in now, number 46. Boyd has the ball. He got turned around a little bit by number 29, Eric Turner, and he is brought down short of the first down. Here's Roger Twyman.
third and a half with a wishbone. Bowles fouled. Good firing over the right side. Got a big hole over there this time. And picks up the first down. You know who really laid some leather on that one? Was Joe Cocozzo, the redshirt freshman, playing the right guard position. He's from Mechanicsville, New York, and he laid a sound, solid block to spring balls. Ball is at the UCLA 44-yard line. Now Horde and Bowles set up in the backfield. Time ticking along at 4:20 to go in the first half. Gerbach back, has protection, pass to the sidelines. The pass is caught. Leroy Horde lost the ball, and who's got it? Bruins have taken away from him. I think. Hold it. Hold on, let's see.
Well, it looked to me like he was down. Whether the ball came out before he hit the ground, I don't even know if it was a catch.
I don't either.
Look from the end zone. Can't see anything there, although he was down, or they both were down before the ball came out. I don't know if either one had possession. They were definitely on the ground before the ball came out.
Man in a white hat is the one you want to watch. Incomplete forward pass.
Let's take another look. It's got to be either incomplete or the man has caught the ball and he was down. Now he doesn't have control on it. Patrick Bates, number six, was in there, and the ball was stuck between the two bodies. Nobody had control of it. I mean, that ball either had to be incomplete, or if it was complete, it was a fumble together and clear for him, so I saw it this way.
Bowles up the middle. It's a good run by Tony. He's brought down at the UCLA 46-yard line. Number 53 making the hit on him. They were simply sophomores.
Yes, of course. It's true. And it may be that again.
I think it should be. That'll be a first Leroy down Horde. As Leroy Horde bolts through over the left side and gets the first for Michigan. Ball will be put at the UCLA 31 with 3:20 to go in the first half.
94 in the blue is Mike Lodish. Strepanek is 75, but Cocozzo, 68, gets a piece of him. 53 is Shaw. Strepanek at 3:40 got a piece of Shaw. Good blocking up front for the Wolverines.
Yeah, Cocozzo now is starting to get into it, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
First down for the Bruin 31. Down game. Starting to work a little bit as Bowles Brown have done a pretty good job. Second down and 8. The ball is at the 29. There's a little delay as Horde breaks a couple of tackles and finds some daylight. That's a tough run by Leroy Horde, and he's got a first down, and he deserves it at the UCLA 15-yard line.
Horde has the power. He's more of a slasher. He doesn't have the great speed that Bowles does, but a good run there picks up a first down.
Five folks in blue shirts had a handle on him and couldn't close the grip. Well, it closed at that time. Marcus Patton. But there's somebody down underneath with authority. Patton is the one whose number's showing. But at 55, look to me.
And Jim Waller all off that group drafted by the NFL.
Loss of about a half a yard on that previous play. Wishbone now. We're back to the outside. He's got his man over there. That's Callaway. And Callaway is thrown out at about the 9-yard line. And he is thrown out by Michael Williams.
Williams is an interesting story. A walk-on last year. This year, the injuries to the defensive secondary and some suspensions. He all of a sudden, as a walk-on second-year player, was in the starting lineup. And Donahue has a rule that if any asks the young man Williams, he says, do you want a scholarship? He says, I'll take it.
Bowles behind the line of scrimmage, trying to hand it off on a reverse to Howard, and Howard is brought down behind the line of scrimmage.
It's down here. They're going to blitz. They're going to be more aggressive. A reverse takes too long to develop. Donahue says, yeah, we had the blitz going, and of course, Bo doesn't like it. Play just takes too long to, you know, you do that out in the middle of the field.
Meeting at Ann Arbor in 82, the Bruins trailed 21-0, came back to win 31-27, and then beat the Wolverines a second time in the Rose Bowl game 24-14. That 1982 team may have been Terry Donahue's best ever at Westwood.
Michigan call. I would think UCLA would call it.
Making the young man think a little bit.
Yeah, make him think a little bit. But now I'm told it was Michigan call. Yeah. I get sources of information from three different directions and they're all wrong.
19-yard line.
Mark Cadamley says he was standing right next to the UCLA bench and they called the timeout.
The defensive coordinator for UCLA, great job he does with those young people.
All right, J.D. Carlson now sets it up at the 26. It'll be a 36-yard try. He's hit one tonight from 46. A lot of leg. Good. Boy, he didn't mess with it. Remember, they're kicking without a tee, and everybody thought a lot of kicks were going to be low and blocked, but not so far this season. He just ripped it. So we got 14 seconds to play in the first half.
Gerbach has got to play better the second half. Johnson has made 8 out of the 9 first downs for UCLA. Gerbach has not really done that much, and he needs to play much better. We were concerned going into the ball game with the pressure of knowing that he was going to start.
6, and here we go with the second half. And this is Brown. Brian is a bit of an... I don't care how smart you are, or how experienced you are, it's going to take you a little time to get used to one.
Well, I think it does take a little bit of time. Of course, Bob Field remained as the defensive coordinator. Steve Axman, who was the offensive coordinator, is gone, and now Greg Robinson, who was a defensive line coach, moves over to offense. So it's a little bit of adjustment, but Robinson was our offensive coach for many years before he moved over.
Woods looking and searching, trying to use some outside quickness as Brian carries the ball again. And she's had a good week, feeling better, and I'm sure watching the ball game and probably not very happy about the way things are going.
I think she keeps Bo in line pretty well.
Third down, 4. Brett Johnson runs away from the pressure. He's got enough daylight, picks up the first down.
The fact that a quarterback.
Brett Johnson has time. Looks like it could be intercepted and is by the linebacker Anderson, Eric Anderson.
Well, here's Anderson again. The tight end is right here. He's going to come to the inside and break to the outside. Anderson will be right on him. Sees it's passed. Covers the tight end. Jams him. Breaks to the outside. That's a good read by the sophomore, Eric Anderson. Take a look at the protection. 5-step drop. Quick passing. Quick release. Three men right around the ball.
Yeah, maybe Brett got a little too confident that time and tried to force it.
Yep.
Well, UCLA intercepted and scored. Let's see what Michigan can do. From the 41-yard line, this is Tony Bowles. And Tony Bowles puts the ball inside the UCLA 48, and that'll be a first down. The tackle made by Shaw.
Picozzo, the big guard, was trying to get out there, got picked off, but Bowles didn't need much help as he got around the car and picked up a first down.
Bowles and Callaway come out now. Horde stays out as the lone back. Howard is in along with McMurtry. McMurtry, I don't think, seen the ball all night.
Well, two tight ends. This is a different formation than we've seen in the first half.
And first down. Number 54 laid a lick on him. That's the inside backer, Craig Davis, for the Bruins.
Bruins arguing the ball had come loose. Michigan keeps it. Skripanek, 75, was down there. They're back to throw. Has time. Got his man. Pass is caught for the tight end, Walker.
Walker is here. He's going to slide in over the middle as the play action goes this way. A guard will pull. Gerbach seems to be settling down. Play action fake. The guard pulls. Top of your screen. Throws it over the middle linebackers. A nice catch.
And just inside the 30 for the first down. Bowles. Meet Shaw again getting a piece of the tackle with Brian Kelly getting the bulk of it. Bowles now 11 carries 51 yards and Horde 12 carries for 52 yards. Seattle beating up Kansas City. And Ballmer handling the Yankees tonight. Robbie's Orioles have been quite a story. Tony Bowles, number 42. The Bruins may have gotten off too soon. Lofted to the corner. McMurtry can't come down with it. The defense on the play by number 32, Randy Beverly.
Well, we were talking about the blitz, and he certainly got it. You saw him pointing before. He was pointing at the linebackers who were blitzing. Watch these two men as they're going to slide up. He was pointing at him a little bit earlier. He saw it coming. He could see it from the alignment of the defensive backs. They're up closer, and when they're up closer, they're up there to cover people.
Well, that was close, though.
Yeah, very close.
J.D. Carlson's out there. 46-yard good, 36 yards good, 43 this drive. In solid, holds it. Plenty of leg and good. So Ken Solom, a quarterback, sophomore, Canyon Country, just north of here, holds, and Michigan now totals 9. And it's 14-9 UCLA. Bowl ball turf, just outstanding condition. How he's making it better. No pressure, good kick. Welburn at the 31. Got a hole. Got a big hole. Foot race. Inside the 10, down at the 5, 4. Eric Turner, the free safety, ran him down. Well, now there is a big play from the special teams.
Well, they messed up last week, but they got it back this week. Michigan special teams giving up 2 touchdowns last week. Comes back to set up a scoring opportunity for the Wolverines. Turner at the very end tries to force a fumble. There's a low angle look at it coming right at you. Take a look at some of the blocks here.
Well, I told you earlier that Wellerman's a former running back. He
yes.
can move it. That's a 44-yard punt, a 63-yard return. And this is Leroy Horde to the 2-yard line, where Eric Turner again makes the tackle for the Bruins.
Tough to tackle these backs for Michigan. You know, Keith, I don't know what Bo said to him at halftime, but whatever it was, he should bottle it and sell it.
Probably. How would you like to walk for it? It takes time to blend people into a team effort. Horde, right at the goal line, but they've stopped him short. Give Marcus Patton some credit for that one.
This is a critical down coming up here, Keith. You want to get in. You don't want to.
You've got Horde. You figure Horde gets the ball. he's in there. Touchdown.
Flag.
But there's a laundry laying on the ground. Durback says it's against UCLA. So does Steve Everett. Gets a touchdown. They're staying out there looking to me like it's going for two.
Well, it's 15-14. They ought to go for two. It would give them a 3-point lead. 1 point doesn't give them anything. It's a 2-point lead and just nope. Gives them a field goal would still allow UCLA to go ahead. Half the distance.
Offside. Offside.
Nope. They penalize on the kickoff.
Well, you can do it on either. It's a new rule this year. You can do it on the X try. That leads me to believe that they're going to go for 1 point. Just kick it. I don't know why they wouldn't have taken it to get halfway closer to the goal line, half the distance.
Okay, you go to who goes to the other side. Gerbach to throw it, gets it away into the end zone, and it is incomplete. As Howard is taken down by Matt. So the three games involving the two conferences on this day. Michigan will kick off from the 40. John Albertson placing it. It's Williams and Brown back for UCLA. In front of him at the six. And
Kenham has been all Michigan in the second half.
Johnson back and has a man underneath. The pass is caught short by Scott Miller.
Get it.
I mean to tell you, J.J. Grant stepped in there with some authority. So did Eric Anderson.
Well, we've been wondering about J.J. Grant. He's been in and out. He's had some knee surgery on those knees the last couple of years. Slides to the outside. Does what a linebacker's supposed to do. Fill the hole, fill the gap. Get some help from Anderson and one of the defensive backs.
So it is fourth and one, and the Bruins are going for it. Here's some good old-fashioned down-home jawbone football right here. Me and you, partner, let's go. Johnson will throw it. Right-handed catch by Randy Austin. Holy cow! What a catch by Austin. Johnson's throwing it. Knocked down the line of scrimmage. He had Farr and Richardson both in that neighborhood, but T.J. Osmond got his hand up, slapped it down. Number 94. And so in comes Velasco. It'll be his first field goal try of the night. He tried one and Tennessee blocked it in the opening game.
He's been good on 32 out of 33 inside the 44 yard line.
This is a 45 yarder and he says he's perfectly happy without the tee. Looks pretty good. So UCLA goes back to the lead by two. Probably a Purdue promotion, right, 10 times?
Well, I think Purdue was underdog most of the time, too.
Yeah, they've had some wars. Here comes Tony Bowles. Back to the 26, 27-yard line. UCLA. Finish Pittsburgh beat Syracuse 30-23. So now Michigan owns the ball at their own 27. First down as we go to the fourth quarter.
Lloyd Carr,
the quarterback.
Excuse me, Lloyd Carr just talking to his defensive troops from Michigan.
And on first down to throw it down the middle.
No. Intended for Derek Walker. Double coverage on him.
Last spring, this is what the Michigan depth chart at quarterback looked like. Taylor, Brown, Odom, Solomon, Urbach. The top two are fifth-year senior quarterbacks. Michigan was very deep in quarterbacks. Demetrius Brown went.
Second down and 10. And a little delay inside with Tony Bowles, and he'll get it up to about the 30, and that'll do it there. And let's join Roger Twible in New York.
Thank you, Keith. Pitt had lost five in a row.
Michigan, 4 out of 10 on third down conversions. Blitz, they pick it up. Ball loose, Bruce Pennett, UCLA ball. Marcus Patton knocked it loose. Mike Lodish covered it.
They have changed the ball game. Defense creates momentum, and other than that, the statistics are pretty much the same, but the turnovers have turned this ball game around.
Loss of five, now 10 more on the penalty, and Johnson pitches to Sean Wills, and Wills on a sweep to the sideline. And Michigan uses the boundary well enough as Abrams and White runs and run him out. And you've got 13 minutes to play in the ball game. Wills remains the lone back for the Bruins with Richardson and Barr, wideouts and Arbuckle. Go to the H-back, going to flank position on third down and 20. Brett Johnson back to throw it, getting some heat. And they got it. All the way back at the 45-yard line, Eric Anderson. Whoa, that was a fierce defensive series for Michigan.
Anderson, an outstanding linebacker. Didn't play a lot last year because he was a freshman, but is in there playing well. Last week he played very well, and again this week.
All right, Maggio is in the punt, 56 and 44 on the night. And it's Welburn back at the 10-yard line for Michigan. Punt is away, hits it high, lazy fly ball. Bearcats called at the 14-yard line. Time remaining, 11:40. Here to Ackman. State of the art. Gerbach gives the ball to Tony Bowles. Bowles gets around the corner and gets out close to the 30-yard line. Mark at the 29. Matt Garvey finally brought it down, but Bowles showed you some experience there. He was patient. He waited.
He likes to run outside. He has more speed than the other running backs for Michigan. Last year he had 7 100-plus games rushing for Michigan.
It's a two-point ball game, 17-15, UCLA. First down, Michigan, 29. Bowles again to the 35. Stacy Ergo, sophomore out of Princeton, California, the tackle for the Bruins. It's a gain of 6. It'll be second down, 4. Well, I'll tell you something. You let that Michigan running game get in rising Bowles to give Tony a little rest. And Leroy has it. And somebody grabbed his hind leg as he started to cut back across the middle. And they get him short of the first down. That right there, Stanford, Oregon, might be one of the big upsets of the day. Washington State over to Laramie had to score late to get that win. It is not easy to win in Laramie, Wyoming. Third down and 1. Bowles is back. Ford has it.
Fumbled it.
UCLA ball. So Bowman Anthony, the tight end in motion, one of the H-backs. Johnson throws it. Touchdown, Anthony. They got three good tight ends on this UCLA team. Foreman Anthony moved into what they have now come to call an H-back position, went in motion, and just slid on into the corner and made the catch.
You saw Austin.
Tony Bowles comes back. They stop him at the 17, short of the 20. So the Wolverines are beleaguered now. 23-15, Mike Adamley with Mark Messner.
Yeah, Keith, remember this guy? 25 pounds lighter, former All-American, now Los Angeles Ram. I'm surprised Bo didn't convince you to suit up.
Well, I think it would have been an opportune thing for me to do. I would have sure loved to have done it, because it's really tearing me up seeing these guys play. It's the first Michigan game really I've ever seen in person without playing.
Still bleed maize and blue. You went wild when they blocked that extra point attempt.
Well, that's a big play. I mean, that leaves a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie the ball game up, and I've got all the confidence in the world in these Wolverines. This is a heck of a football team. And
17, Gerbach to throw it. Goes underneath with it. And it is incomplete, intended for Greg McMurtry. It was not a particularly well-thrown ball.
Let's go back and take a look at that missed extra point that would have put him up by 9. The hold was good. Ooh, kick was a little low. He had some Wolverines that were really over the top.
Velasco was 99 out of 100 coming up to that kick. Second down and 10. That's forward in motion. Bowles catches underneath. Brought down at the 24. I'll tell you what, those corners for UCLA have played well, too. They have not tested the corners. Tried Beverly once. That was about it. Time called by Michigan at 4:47 to play. 4:47 to play. Third down, 3 for the Michigan Wolverines.
Big play here, yeah.
Fumbled it, and UCLA took it 41 yards to take an 8-point lead. Passes to the tight end underneath, and the play is broken up by Matt Darby. Turn it over. So Michigan fumbles it away to give UCLA a chance to build an 8-point lead, and now the Bruins have returned the favor. J.J. Grant covered it.
Good hit here. Now watch Key. I'm coming from the right side. David Key, 26, shakes it loose with a good crushing tackle. The Wolverines get the big break that they need. Now it's time for the offense to do something.
UCLA 43-yard line. First down, Michigan. Yeah, it's been a grinder.
It has been. A lot of turnovers, a lot of key points in this ball game.
Tony Bowles in motion, Gerbach to throw it. Bruins try to get to him, gets his pass away to Walker, the tight end. And he's down at the UCLA 32. That's the play from this side. They ran the last time from the other side, trying to pick up their first down, and it didn't work.
The coverage was different. This time it was a zone, nobody was riding him. Right. The last time it was a man coverage with Darby really jamming him.
I would think UCLA could play him head up, wouldn't you? You would try.
For the secondary, they could.
Yeah. Whew. Ball is away, and the pass is completed. But it's one of those things that turns over your stomach a couple of times before it gets to your receiver, because he threw it a long way, and it was a blue shirt looking at it. Chris Callaway caught it.
Michigan has 2 timeouts remaining. Time is not a problem. Over 3 minutes, about 3 minutes to go.
Second down and two. That's Leroy Horde into the middle and close to the first down. Craig Davis, who is a good inside linebacker for UCLA, popped in. Don't want to measure. They say it's third down. Third and half a yard. Over the top, Leroy Horde, first down at the 20 of UCLA at 2 minutes, 23 seconds. Clock stopping while the chains are moved.
Now, if you're Michigan, what you got to be doing on the sideline is sending somebody to get your best two-point play. If you do score, you can at least tie the ball game. If you want to have your best play call, you don't want to be surprised if and when you do score.
Pass, Bowles, 10, 8, first down, first and goal, Michigan.
A good throw and a good call. UCLA's defense was dropping off, protecting the inside. Back out of the backfield on a little slant to the sideline, picks up the first down.
Make it the seven. First and goal from the seven.
This is the area, Keith, where it's tough to throw because the defense only has 10 yards of the end zone and about 7 yards of the field to cover.
They're going to run it right here. Go to their wishbone, leg it in the game. Leroy Horde to the 5-4-3. Second down and goal. 2 minutes to play in the game.
You still need to score as quickly as you can. Because if you don't make the 2 points, then you need to get the ball back and try a field goal. You're not sure you're going to get that in.
Call to time. That's UCLA's timeout. We'll be back with a finish between the Bruins and the Wolverines after a word from our ABC station. And goal for the Wolverines. They need a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie. Earlier today, there were two other games matching the Big Ten Pac-10. USC beat Ohio State 42-3, and Wisconsin lost to California 20-14. Second and goal. Gerbach has the ball. Sets, pressure, throw, away. Beyond the playing field, he had his tight end, Derek Walker, in the corner. He was open. But the pressure was coming from Kelly and Lodish, and he threw it away.
Good read by Turner, 29, covering. He saw something in the backfield. That's a smart play by Gerbach. Just throw it away. I like the call.
30. Gerbach will throw it, throws it hard into the end zone. It is touchdown, Walker. So they go back to the tight end. My guys had 1:35 to play in the game.
Well, Keith loves the tight ends, and here he is right here. He's just going to release to the inside, and nobody's going to be in the middle of the field to cover him. Linebacker split. One blitzes, the other goes after the back. Darby, I believe it is, covers the tight end, but is not there in time. This is a big play that they should have had diagrammed and ready to go about 3 or 4 minutes ago.
23-21, they're going for two to tie. At 1:35 to play. Ford, the lone back. Howard in motion. Pressure coming, pass away, into the end zone, slapped around, incomplete, no good. And UCLA leads by two.
Minutes instead of a minute and a half. Kicked it short, didn't kick it very well.
No, only kicked for 4 yards. So the Bruin defense standing on the sideline waiting. There's the onside kick. That's a good one. Michigan's got it at the 40. The ball ricocheted high in the air, and Beta Murray came down with it at the UCLA 39-yard line. Oh, my goodness. Now that Bruin defense is bunched, you've got to come back on the field.
You couldn't ask for a better onside kick. As good as this is, the one last week was just as bad. Hops over everybody, and your man is right there to recover.
Well, they're going to bring it back. They don't give them the ball that deep. They brought it back
to where you recover.
Well, I think they brought it back to where it hit somebody. He had that ball down at the 40 when Murray got it.
We're giving it on the 46. Well, you can't draw it up any better than that.
Nope. Must have hit somebody back up at the 46-yard line. Well, Michigan's got its chance. 1:33 to play. The Bruins come after Gerbach. Throws it. And it's complete to Chris Callaway right at the marker. And Chris is going to get up long away from it. Whew.
This is an area where a young quarterback who is not as experienced in running these two-minute offenses, the things he needs to know is number one, I don't want to throw an interception. If I throw an interception, I don't get another play, and I don't get a chance to win the game. Number two, you don't want to take a sack. A sack takes you further back out of the field position. You've got two timeouts and a minute and 25 seconds to play. He's in good shape with the time.
On second down and one. Here comes the blitz. They pick it up. Pass caught by Bowles. They got the first down as Bowles goes to the UCLA 27-yard line. Craig Davis wrote him out. Clock stops as they move the chains.
Well, they're blitzing, and when you blitz, everybody is man-to-man. Here's Bowles. He's going to come down and run a little out pattern out of the backfield. It's a good route by Bowles. Good protection in the backfield. And another play, and they haven't used their timeouts because both plays have been out of bounds.
And the clock shows 1:20. What a seesaw, emotional grinder this ball game has been.
Keith, what do? Do you blitz or do you lay back?
I'd go after. But they hand it off inside. Antonio Bowles carries. And doesn't get much. And they went after.
Well, there's a point in time where Bob Field, the defensive coordinator, has got to make a decision.
1:10 to play in the game.
Xerex presents the Great American Torture Test.
Talking on the telephone. I don't know if it was mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, or a coach, but somebody had called him and said, hey,
well, he's 42 yards field goal right now. If Michigan doesn't do anything else offensively, he can make a 42-yarder. So the key for Gerbach is don't turn it over and don't take a sack. Incompletions are all right.
Second down and 8. Little drop off on the screen to Tony Bowles. He's got some daylight. Go to the sidelines. He doesn't go to the sidelines. Now he does, and the Bruins wrestle him out inside the 10-yard line. Whoa, was that a biggie?
That's an excellent call, but it was in some ways, it was a lucky call because UCLA was in a zone defense. And when you're in zone, you drop back. If this had been a man coverage, the screening back would have had a linebacker right in his pocket. 68 is Cocozo. Bowles makes the catch. If it had been man coverage, it would have been man up there in his face.
The ball is at the UCLA 9, having stopped the clock at 58 seconds, and it's first down and goal, Michigan. Leroy Horde into the stack for a yard. Brad Bryson, Mike Lodish, a whole bunch of blue-shirted folks over there. Lodish on that tackle. Time called now by Michigan. Each team with one timeout remaining. Second down and goal from the 8.
Keith, I think you keep the ball on the ground. The strength of this team is in the running backs.
That running back into the middle.
You've got enough yardage. You don't want to be too conservative. You've got plays that are better than others. The other thing you've got to think of offensively is what plays are good against blitzes. Because UCLA certainly needs to cause something to happen. They don't need to lay back at this time.
Crowd gets into it. Ball goes to Bowles. He's got a little room. Goes to the five, down to the three. Now they've got it just about the right place for Carlson. Eric Turner made that tackle. Otherwise, Bowles scored. UCLA spends its last timeout. And that stops your clock at 35 seconds. Third and goal. Michigan has one more run at it, and then the try.
It's certainly a no sure thing.
No sure.
Got to run it to the right.
That's where the daylight is. Option. Gerback. Uh-oh.
He moved it over in the center just to get it centered in the middle of the goalpost.
Well, they didn't try to score, did they?
Nope.
Well, they are trusting their place kicker. The clock is running. They're going to take it on down and have just enough time to snap. Five, four, and they stop it at three. Well, the whole thing comes down to J.D. Carlson. To Ken Solomon, who must handle the snap from Steve Everett. Watch three teenagers handle the most important moment of the ball game.
Well put. And what you have is the special teams for Michigan with an opportunity to win one, where last week with Rocket Ismail running two touchdowns back, they really lost it.
24 yards. Carlson, 46, 36, 43, 24. He'll be an MVP. He just grew a foot.
He was smiling before the ball went through. He enjoys it so much.
Well, it's been a heck of an effort by two very good football teams. I don't know what it proves. Maybe nothing, except it's an exciting game played by the collegiate kids. Penalty. All sorts of things could happen here. There's one tick remaining on the clock. Your Chevy players in the ball game, obviously J.D. Carlson with four field goals, and depending on what happens in this final second, the winner. Brett Johnson.
For Terry Donahue, he has beaten the Big Ten teams five straight. That appears to be in jeopardy tonight, but it's a tough loss for he and the UCLA Bruins.
Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund to reward outstanding students for their academic achievements and to help those who need some financial help.
You got to squib kick this, Keith.
Well, they were penalized because the Michigan kids were out on the field and they do squib kick it. They just roll it down there and it is.
That's all right.
Clock doesn't start.
Yeah.
Doesn't start. They still got Mark Estrick covered the ball, so you still got that 1 second. He accepted the ball in a down position. So it's considered a fair catch. And he may have even called fair catch. In fact, I don't normally look that far upfield.
No, he didn't. He just caught it and covered it.
But you can fair catch or kick
a kickoff just as easily as you can a punt. And what this does now, it gives UCLA the football at their own 42. And playing center field for Michigan, Ada Murray is also going back there with him. And Brett Johnson loads it up and lets it go. That's no, it's not Johnson, it's Jim Bonds. Bonds, the strong-armed sophomore from Valencia, was in for the final play. And he threw it as far as he could throw it, all the way down to the five-yard line, and it was incomplete. And it was a heck of a football game as the Michigan Wolverines win it by a score of 24 to 23.